Welcome to our celebration at the Church of Our Lady of Pompeii. Today we celebrate the 30th Sunday in Ordinary Time, and we have the joy of thanking God with Archbishop Silvano Tomasi on his 50th anniversary of ordination to the priesthood in this very Church of Our Lady of Pompeii. We remember also the intentions of Leonardo Cesare. We welcome among us His Eminence Theodore Cardinal McCarrick, Bishop Nicholas DiMarzio, and the Provincial Superior of the Scalabrinians, Very Reverend Moisir Balem, together with many friends of Archbishop Tomasi. You should have these pamphlets, the 50th anniversary pamphlets. We will begin our celebration with the song, Praise to the Lord, which is in the pamphlet toward the back, page 4.
Please stand, we'll sing our entrance hymn, Praise to the Lord.
Praise to the Lord, the Almighty, the King of creation. O my soul, praise Him, for He is your health and salvation. Come all who hear, now to His altar. Joining in glad adoration, know that Deus beate del cielo, know that Deus gentili di tutta la terra. Cantate lui che l'universo creò, somma sapienza splendore. Praise to the Lord who shall prosper our work and defend us. Surely His goodness and mercy shall daily attend us. Ponder anew what the Almighty can do, who with His love will befriend us. Laudate Dio Padre che dona ogni bene. Laudate Dio ricco di grazia e perdono. Cantate noi che tanto vi a dare l'unico figlio. Praise to the Lord, the Almighty, the King of creation. O my soul, praise Him, for He is your health and salvation. Come all who hear, now to His altar draw near, joining in glad adoration.
In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Peace be with you.
And with your spirit.
Dear friends, my brothers and sisters, as we prepare to celebrate this Eucharist, we place ourselves in God's presence and ask Him forgiveness for all our sins. Almighty God, have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Gloria in excelsis Deo,
et in terra pax hominibus, bonae voluntatis, lauda. Gratias agibus tibi, propter magnam gloriam tuam, Domine Deus ex celestis, Deus Pater omnipotens, Domine Genite, Jesu Christe, Domine Deus, Agnus Dei, Filius Patris, qui tollis peccata mundi, miserere peccata mundi, suscite de peccatione nostra, qui sedes ad extrema partis, miserere nobis, coniam tu solus sanctus, tu solus Dominus, tu solus Altissimus, Jesu Christe, cum Sancto Spiritu, in gloria Dei Patris.
Let us pray. Almighty ever-living God, increase our faith, hope, and charity, and make us love what you command, so that we may merit what you promise. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
Tonight's first reading will be read in English, and it can be found on page 67 of today's Missal. A reading from the book of the prophet Jeremiah. Thus says the Lord, shout with joy for Jacob, exult at the head of the nations, proclaim your praise and say, the Lord has delivered his people, the remnant of Israel. Behold, I will bring them back from the land of the north. I will gather them from the ends of the world, with the blind and the lame in their midst, the mothers and those with child. They shall return as an immense throng. They departed in tears, but I will console them and guide them. I will lead them to brooks of water on a level road, so that none shall stumble. For I am a father to Israel. Ephraim is my firstborn. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The Lord has done great things for us. We are filled with joy. The Lord has done great things for us. We are filled with joy. When the Lord brought back the captives of Zion, we were like men dreaming. Then our mouth was filled with laughter, and our tongue with rejoicing. The Lord has done great things for us. We are filled with joy. Then they said among the nations, the Lord has done great things for them. The Lord has done great things for us. We are glad indeed. The Lord has done great things for us. We are filled with joy. Restore our fortunes, O Lord, like the torrents in the southern desert. Those that sow in tears shall reap rejoicing. The Lord has done great things for us. We are filled with joy. Although they go forth weeping, carrying the seed to be sown, they shall come back in rejoicing, carrying their sheaves. The Lord has done great things for us. We are filled with joy.
Dalla lettera agli Ebrei. Ogni sommo sacerdote è scelto fra gli uomini e per gli uomini viene costituito tale nelle cose che riguardano Dio, per offrire doni e sacrifici per i peccati. Egli è in grado di sentire giustizia compassione per quelli che sono nell'ignoranza e nell'errore, essendo anche lui rivestito di debolezza. A causa di questa, egli deve offrire sacrifici per i peccati, anche per se stesso, come fa per il popolo. Nessuno attribuisce a se stesso questo onore, se non chi è chiamato da Dio, come Aronne. Nello stesso modo, Cristo non si attribuì a se stesso la gloria del sommo sacerdote, ma colui che gli disse: «Tu sei il mio figlio, oggi ti ho generato». Gliela conferì come è detto in un altro passo: «Tu sei sacerdote per sempre, secondo l'ordine di Melchisedec». Parola di Dio.
Rendiamo grazie a Dio. Please stand.
Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia. Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia. Our Savior Jesus Christ destroyed death and brought life to life through the gospel. Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Mark.
Glory to you, O Lord.
As Jesus was leaving Jericho with his disciples and a sizable crowd, Bartimaeus, a blind man, the son of Timaeus, sat by the roadside begging. On hearing that it was Jesus of Nazareth, he began to cry out and say, "Jesus, son of David, have pity on me." And many rebuked him, telling him to be silent. But he kept calling out all the more, "Son of David, have pity on me." Jesus stopped and said, "Call him." So they called the blind man, saying to him, "Take courage, get up. Jesus is calling you." He threw aside his cloak, sprang up, and came to Jesus. Jesus said to him in reply, "What do you want me to do for you?" The blind man replied to him, "Master, I want to see." Jesus told him, "Go your way, your faith has saved you." Immediately he received his sight and followed him on the way. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Dear friends, the Eucharist that we celebrate tonight is the highest expression of thanks to the Lord for the gift of Himself, for the gift of His love, for support, for forgiveness. I am deeply grateful to celebrate this Eucharist with a community of faith that is also our community of friends. Allow me to thank for this presence His Eminence Cardinal Theodore McCarrick, a mentor and friend of a long time, Bishop Nicholas DiMarzio of Brooklyn, who has given us an example of how we should love and welcome new immigrants. Father Moacir Balen, the Provincial Superior of the Scalabrinian community, the religious family to which I belong, the pastor of this church, Father Walter, that has insisted, I give thanks to God and this beautiful church of Our Lady of Pompeii, where for many years I offer my daily mass since my priestly ordination 50 years ago. To all the priests and friends present, to all of you, my warm thanks. As I look back, I see my long journey guided by the Lord's providence with love and surprises. My ordination here in New York in 1965, service to the church by the development with Father Lirio of the Center for Migration Studies, and then the updating of the pastoral ministry of the Scalabrinian community, then a period of service to the U.S. Conference of Catholic Bishops in Washington, and finally service to the Holy See in the Horn of Africa, and then in Rome and at the UN and other organizations in Geneva. At all different stages of this journey, a lot of activities have been carried out. A lot of people have been helpful. And together we tried to implement some of the innovations, the insights for modern society that Vatican Council II had outlined for all of us. It has been a long season of steady changes to meet the demands of modern society, of the men and women of today with their anxieties, their doubts, their aspirations for a better quality of life for everybody. Pope Francis has announced the Holy Year of Mercy. For the little good that has been done, I thank the Lord from the depth of my heart. It has been a privilege and a joy to follow and participate in the life of the Church from the conclusion of Vatican Council II to today. For the faults and limits and lost occasions to do some good, the mercy of God may forgive and remedy. The blind man, Timaeus, of the Gospel of Mark we just heard, is a good example to follow whatever the story of our life might be. He is determined to reach out to Jesus. And Jesus calls him. Anxious for this encounter, Timaeus sprang up, as the evangelist underlined. And he came to Jesus, and the extraordinary happened. Timaeus received back his sight and his hope in life. May we as well spring up and celebrate always our encounter with Jesus so that we may exclaim with the words of this Eucharist's responsorial psalm, "The Lord has done great things for us. We are filled with joy."
Please stand.
I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy, Catholic, and apostolic church. I confess to one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, as I look for the forward to the resurrection of the dead, the life of the world to come. Amen.
That the Lord may continue to bless Archbishop Silvano Tomasi in his service to the Universal Church, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the Lord may continue to bless the Scalabrinian congregation with more vocations to the priesthood and religious life in their service to the migrants, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the Lord may continue to bless the church in New York, so that it might become an example of welcoming for all migrants, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Per la Chiesa, perché sia sempre l'immagine paziente di Dio, che pieno di bontà e di misericordia, ascolta, soccorre ed aiuta. Preghiamo.
Ascoltaci,
oh Signore. Perché il mondo riconosca la sua cecità e domandi al Cristo Salvatore la vista spirituale e la salvezza. Preghiamo.
Ascoltaci, oh Signore.
Per i genitori, gli educatori e quanti sono chiamati ad essere guida dei giovani, perché sappiano essere per loro orientamento sicuro verso il Signore, fonte di luce vera. Preghiamo.
Ascoltaci, oh Signore.
O God of goodness, you have indeed filled us with joy at the works you have done in our world. Hear these our prayers and graciously grant them according to your will, through Jesus Christ, our Lord.
Amen. Please be seated.
To Today at the offertory, we will carry significant gifts, which show some of the aspects of the vocation of Archbishop Tomasi. 1. Flowers for the liturgy, which reminds us of the 50th anniversary of Father Silvano Tomasi. 2. A book, which reminds us of Father Silvano as founder of the Center for Migration Studies, dedicated to social research on migration. 3. Suitcase and shoes, which remind us of the Scalabrinian charisma to work for migrants. 4. The globe, which reminds us of the international work of Archbishop Silvano in Ethiopia, Djibouti, Eritrea, and now at the United Nations in Geneva. 5. The picture of Blessed John Baptist Scalabrini, father to the migrants and founder of the Scalabrini congregation. Together with the offerings that will be brought to the altar, we offer all our sacrifices and good deeds of the week. The ushers will come for the first collection, which will go to support the needs of our church, and after communion, the second collection for the needs of our community. The offertory song will be Ave Maria, sung by the choir.
By the mystery of this world. Are you, Lord God of all creation? In your goodness, we have this wine to offer, fruit of the vine and work of human hands. It will become for us our spiritual drink. Pray, brethren, that our sacrifice may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
Lord, accept the sacrifice and praise, glory, and safety for this day, our good church.
Look, we pray, O Lord, on the offering we make to your majesty, that whatever is done by us in your service may be directed above all to your glory. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your heart.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For through his paschal mystery, he accomplished a marvelous deed, by which he has freed us from the yoke of sin and death, summoning us to the glory of being now called a chosen race, a royal priesthood, a holy nation, a people for your own possession, to proclaim everywhere your mighty works, for you have called us out of darkness into your own wonderful light. And so with the angels and archangels, with thrones and dominations, and with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory, and without end we acclaim.
Sanctus, Sanctus, Sanctus Dominus, Deus Sabaoth, plenis in celi et terra, gloria tua. Hosanna, 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 in excelsis. Benedictus, Benedictus, qui venit in nomine Domini. Benedictus qui venit in nomine Domini. Hosanna, 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 Hosanna in excelsis.
Please kneel.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like in the life that you fall,
so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving thanks, he broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you.
In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me.
the mystery of faith.
Mortem tuam annunciamus Domini, et tuam resurrexitonem confitemur. Donec venias.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit.
Lord, remember your church spread throughout the world. Bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Timothy, and other bishops, and all the clergy.
Remember our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with Blessed Scalabrini, and all the saints and the blessed apostles, and all who have pleased you throughout the ages, we merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ.
Through him, with him, in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Savior's command, and for my divine teaching, we dare to say,
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our day, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await a blessed hope and the coming of our Savior Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will. You live and reign forever and ever.
Amen. Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
Jesus Christ,
Lamb of God,
you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us.
Lamb of God,
you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace.
Lord Jesus Christ, Son of the Lord. Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof. Alone say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
May the body of Christ keep me safe for eternal life. May the blood of Christ keep me safe for eternal life.
As we come to the altar to receive the body and blood of Christ, we renew our faith in him and commit ourselves to follow him till the ends of the world. Let us approach the altar with great humility and devotion. The communion songs will be sung by the choir.
seduce him. For the final blessing, I like first of all to thank even Cardinal Dolan. He sent a letter saying that because he's in Rome for the synod, he couldn't be here tonight. And also Bishop Murphy of Long Island, he said that I think he was ordained the same year as Archbishop Silvano, and he couldn't be here tonight, but he sent his congratulations to Archbishop Silvano. But now I want to ask Cardinal McCarrick to say a few words, because for a long, long time he has been a friend not only of the Archbishop but also of the Scalabrinis. And then after Cardinal we have Bishop Di Marzio. The Archbishop Silvano said, Di Marzio, we can call him the Bishop of all migrants, because all his life, since I know him for many, many years, he's always been in the middle and also leader in the work for migrants. So first of all, His Eminence Cardinal McCarrick.
De Silvano. Dear brother and friend, it is an extraordinary privilege to be here celebrating this very important day in your life, and in a certain real sense in the life of the Church in the United States, because you have touched it in a very beautiful way and affected it in a very special way. Your Excellency Bishop Di Marzio, who is one of my favorite sons. I have a lot of sons, but he's one of the favorite ones, and it's always a great privilege to be with him, and to celebrate with him is a real special joy. Father Provincial, thank you for letting me be part of this celebration. Father Walter, thank you for your many kindnesses to me, and I do appreciate it. We have also, I want to mention the brilliant director, National Director of the Society for the Propagation of all the Holy Father's works in the United States. Father Small has been always there for any good thing that happens in the United States. Father Small is there. That's why I expected him to be here today, and I'm glad that he was. My dear brother priest, I want to greet the deacon, who is also one of my sons. See, I've been around for a long time, and have been very prolific during those years. But it's hard to say enough about Silvano. It's hard to say enough about him. I'm a New Yorker by birth, or at least by ordination, and I got to know him in his early years. And you could see this amazing energy for the Lord, energy for the Lord. There is nothing too hard for him, not just to do, but to do well. He has touched the Church in the United States, as now in these past few years, he has touched the Church throughout the world. And I think it's a great blessing for us that we have him, that we have him here, that we're with him as he celebrates these 50 years of priesthood. He has not just touched the Church, but touched the lives of thousands and thousands and thousands of people. Not just because he had a job to do, but because he had a life to live for them. And it's that life that he lived for them which is so beautiful and so demanding of us to try to do a little of what he has done so well, so energetically, and so kindly. I'm 10 years older than he, but in those 10 years, I have not accomplished 2% of what Archbishop Silvano Tomasi has accomplished. And so it is really a humbling experience to be with him now and say, thanks be to God for what the Lord has let you do. Thanks be to God for what the Mother of God, who loves our refugees and our migrants and those who are without shelter, who loves them so much and who has been with you in a very special, wonderful way, all your life, but in a special way, these 50 years. What a grace it has been for me to be here to be able to say a few words. And I think I, having gotten the example from his homily, which was beautiful and short, I do not want my remarks to be longer than the homily. So God bless you, Silvano, for many, many years to come.
It's very hard to Father Carlo McCarrick. He says it all so well. But I must add my homage to my friend of almost 40 years. First met him at the Center for Migration Studies. We worked together in Washington, the Migration Office of the Conference, and the Pontifical Council, and kept in touch all these years. As the Cardinal said, he has given extraordinary service to the Church. He's used his intelligence for the good of migrants and those others in need in our world. He's a great example of the Scalabrinian charism of working for migrants and with the migrants and studying the issues of migration. I tip my hat to him, thank him for his friendship, and ask that he continue working because he has still much to give. God bless you.
Let us pray. May your sacraments, O Lord, we pray, perfect in us what lies within them, that what we now celebrate in signs, we may one day possess in truth, through Christ our Lord. May the Lord bless you and keep you.
Amen. Amen.
May he let his face shine upon you and show you his mercy.
Amen.
May he turn his countenance towards you.
Amen. Amen.
May the blessing of Almighty God, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit descend upon you and remain with you forever.
Amen.
The Mass is ended. In the name of the Lord, go forth in peace.
Thanks be to God.
And now you are all invited downstairs for a nice supper together. We have food for everybody, so come down and we enjoy the evening together.
Maybe we'll take a picture in front of the altar or the priest.
Go ahead.
Do
you
want to
do a photo in front of
As we go back to our homes, let us bring the joy and commitment we have learned in this Eucharistic celebration. We promise to follow the migrant church Christ with devotion and commitment. The recessional song is Immaculate Mary in the booklet, page 4.
Ecstasy, why don't you go down in the front then? I mean, in the front row?
Yeah, you can take
it. No, we're going to take a picture.
Immaculate Mary, your praises we sing. You reign now in heaven. We, Jesus, our King. Ave, Ave, Ave Maria. Ave, Ave Maria. In heaven the blessed, your glory proclaim. On earth we, your children, invoke your fair name. Ave, Ave, Ave Maria. Ave, Ave Maria. We pray for Church upon earth, and bless Holy Mary, the land of our birth. Ave, Ave, Ave Maria. Ave, Ave Maria. Immaculate Mary, your praises we sing. You reign now in heaven with Jesus our King. Ave, 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 Ave.